Hello friends, welcome to our channel Piping Mantra. In this video, we are going to learn about different pipe welds. As we know, pipe welding is a method of joining two pipes or pipe to fitting or flange or valve together. This process is called pipe fabrication. So before jumping to directly on the topic, let's first understand installation of piping systems. The installation of piping systems follows its fabrication, and this installation of pipe can be accomplished by two primary ways or combinations of both, which are shop fabricated and field erected and install, and field fabricate and install. Commonly, the butt welded piping is NPS 2 inches and above. The goal of all projects is to do as much welding as possible in controlled environment of fabrication shop in order to minimize the costlier field welding, and while it would be nice to be able to fabricate whole piping system and ship them to site in one piece, this is of course impossible. So here comes the shop fabrication and field fabrication in picture. Shop fabrication is, generally speaking, any pipe, fittings and components that are assembled by welding into spool assemblies at the fabricator's facility. The spools are then labeled with an identifier and transported to the job site for installation. These spools will fit within predetermined shipping box. Each spool piece needs its own identifier marked on the piece itself in some fashion that will make it easy to know where its destination is in the facility and or where it belongs in a multi-spool system of pipe. This will allow the installer to efficiently stage the piece and ready it for installation. The environment is only a factor when work has to be done in an open air structure or other outdoor installation like tank farm, pipeline, pipe rack or yard piping, etc. Working in an open air structure will require protection from the elements like rain, snow, wind, cold, etc. There may additionally be a requirement to work in elevated areas on scaffolding and otherwise. All of this can have a potential impact on safety and efficiency. The big advantage to shop fabrication is the controlled environment in which it's done. This includes the quality control aspect, better equipment, generally speaking, routine methodology of how a piece of work progresses through the shop, and better control through a developed routine of required documentation. Field fabrication and installation is exactly what it means. The pipe is fabricated on site, either directly at the place where it is mounted or in a temporary accommodation in the field. A number of factors will determine whether it is profitable to fabricate pipe on site, like type of project, size and scope of project, pipe size and material, accessibility of the equipment, surface treatment after fabrication, weather conditions, availability of qualified personnel, time available to do the job, etc. Let's now discuss advantages of field fabrication. Only raw material like pipe, fittings, valves, etc. needs to be shipped to the site location. This is much easier to handle and store than multi-plane configurations of prefabricated pipe. No time-consuming need to carefully crib, tie down and choke prefabricated spool pieces for transport to the job site. It has reduced risk of damage to spool pieces. More efficient opportunity to fabricate around unexpected obstacles like structural steel, duct, cable tray, etc. Fabricate as you install reduces the rework risk assumed when prefabricating spools or the cost related to field verification prior to shop fabrication. The field routing installation of pipe through an array of insufficiently documented locations of existing pipe and equipment on a retrofit project is quite frequently more effective than attempting to prefabricate pipe based on dimensional assumptions. Now, let's discuss the disadvantages of field fabrication as well. Weather is arguably the biggest deterrent. If the facility under construction is not enclosed, then protection from the elements we discussed above will have to be provided. Then, when welding has to be done in conditions that are not environmentally controlled, then preheating will be required if the ambient temperature, that is not the metal surface temperature, is 0 degree Fahrenheit or below. in a new facility as opposed to having to route piping through an array of poorly located existing pipe and equipment, field fabrication of butt welded pipe is not as efficient and cost effective as shop fabrication. Concerns about safety and efficiency when working in a facility while it is in operation in advance of a turnaround or to begin advance work on a plant expansion. Now, let's look at the reasons why shop welding is better than field welding. First, components are at a constant temperature. Fabricators are more comfortable in the position. Easier inspection methods. Constant voltage. Removed from potentially hydrocarbon-rich environments. Better welded joints, in my opinion. More choices for filler metal. Generally speaking, threaded, socket weld, grooved, and other proprietary type joints that do not require butt welding are field fabricated and installed. Butt welding of small bore, that is NPS 1.5 inch and less, are very often field fabricated and installed because of the added risk of damage during transport in prefabricated form from the shop to the site. Now, there are four categories of weld names which are usually used in EPC projects: shop welds, field welds, field fit up welds, and tack welds. We will discuss each one of these in detail now. Shop weld. A shop weld in piping refers to a weld that is performed on a pipe assembly within a fabrication shop, meaning the pipes and fittings are joined together in a controlled environment before being transported to the installation site. And typically, pipe components are assembled into prefabricated spools in the shop, which include all necessary welds and fittings ready to be installed on site. Spool piece. It is an assembly fabricated in the pipe fabrication shop that could consist of pipe, fittings, flanges, attachments, and on some projects, walls and instruments which would be ready to install on site. Commonly, spools are fabricated for butt welded piping systems for NPS 2 inches and above. The components of spool are butt welded pipe fittings and flanges welded on branch connections like weldolet, socolet, threadolet and stubbin connection, and welded on pipe support attachment like trunnion, dummy leg, base plate support and pipe shoe or R pad. Spool number. It is a unique number assigned to a spool piece used for identifying and tracking the spool piece from design to installation. Shipping box. Sometimes called a shipping container or just box. This has a fixed set of three dimensions that into which any spool piece can fit in a square, not skewed or diagonal position. Even though no box or container may really exist, all spool pieces are designed to fit within its limits. Handling of the spool piece is easier when the spool pieces are smaller in size. The three dimensions are 3 meter into 3 meter into 12 meter or 10 feet into 10 feet into 40 feet in general as per factory standard. Your project will establish its own dimensions, so you must check with your piping lead for any project specific requirement. These spools are generally hydro tested on fabrication shop for weld inspection. Next is field weld or FW. Once the spool arrive in the field, some can be welded together at grade, making larger spools to be hauled into place. This often place in the heated field erected shelter with the spool's support on stands. This is more expensive compared to shop welding as we may need to erect scaffolding, tarpaulins, additional safety measures, working in cramped quarters, exposure to hot or cold climate conditions, and the higher incident of rejected welds. The end preparation of the pipe is a beveled end for butt welding. Natural weld occurs at all the flanges, whereas break between pipe and fittings, that is field weld location, must be selected. However, much more is required of the designer that just placing field weld locations also requires an effort to understand and consider the needs of construction. Therefore, judgment calls are required by the designer. The considerations are the field weld FW, field fit up weld FFW should be located whenever possible where the welder can perform the weld without scaffolding, ladders or other temporary means. The ideal location for a welder is above a platform, floor or something on which the welder can stand safely and comfortably This is accounting for the ease of installation. Do consider the ease of installation when locating FW and FFW. Be aware of the constraints, obstacles, etc. in the area which the spool piece is to be installed. Try to anticipate the best locations for the field position welds. A good example of this is at the branch to header welds in the pipe racks. While the position welds can be in horizontal pipes or vertical welding, or in vertical pipes, that is horizontal welding, it is best to avoid horizontal welding in a vertical pipe. Horizontal welding poses the most problems for the welders because the molten metal tends to drip, necessitating enhanced welding practices and extra care to overcome this difficulty. Going back to the pipe rack example, instead of placing the field weld at the header branch fitting, consider placing the field weld at the first elbow of the branch line in the horizontal run. Also, avoid field welds in a 45-degree plane. Look at the surrounding piping and steel. Avoid locating position welds in tight areas that will be difficult or impossible for a welder to maneuver in. Look at the pipe routing. Does the piping run through floor, wall, and/or platform penetrations? If so, more field welds may be required in order to create straight run spools without bends that can be threaded through the openings. Locate the field welds above the floor or platform. The FW or FFW should be located whenever possible so spool pieces are self-supported without the need for temporary support or blocking up to keep the spool piece in place during installation. Field welds must be a minimum of 600 mm from any support center line. Make field weld placement consistent for similarly run piping configurations. When you are checking to be sure your spool piece fits in the shipping box, be sure you do not fall into the trap of only looking at the dimensions on the isometric. You must always remember there are undimensioned items that will add to the size of your spool piece. Some of these undimensioned items are half the outside diameter of pipe, half the outside diameter of a flange, a valve handwheel or operator only if the valve is being installed in the shop, a pipe stub or structural shape that is welded to the spool piece. It could be part of an attachment to a support, anchor, guide, a dummy support, a support trunnion, a shoe, a directional anchor, etc. Often seen on heat treated or alloy piping. Now let's discuss field fit up weld, that is FFW. The difference between a FW and a FFW weld is that an additional length of pipe is added to the calculated dimension at a FFW for field trim allowance. No such allowance is provided at a FW. This extra length can vary. Usually it is 150 mm additional length. This type of weld is used when piping design does not have information that enables them to establish a definite dimension for a spool piece. Examples of this situation include having only preliminary vendor information, that is equipment, instruments, etc., or not knowing the exact location of a point to which the spool piece is to be connected. The field fit-up weld is used only when necessary. It is your last consideration. The additional 6 inches is not reflected in the dimension shown on the isometric. The preferred location is in a horizontal run. However, in case of tie with equipment or any other vendor who is having separate fabrication facility, this can be 3-directional FFW. Here you can see through an example. Field welds will have to be inspected. If it's piping, there will generally be an operational step to have non-destructive testing performed to verify weld quality. This is an accepted practice under API 570. These inspections can be performed using high and low level X-ray and ultrasonic inspection techniques. However, the latter is generally used to verify enough base material metal to be welded before field work. The X-ray technique requires coordination with operations and other crafts in the area to prevent accidental radiation exposure. Strategically placed FFW welds for a final hookup should be considered in places where there is a reason to believe field adjustment will be necessary. Common places where an FFW is beneficial are between exchangers, vessels, and pumps in parallel. Pumps in particular require this in order to ensure that the finished piping does not impose unnecessary loads on the nozzles. However, do not go overboard with FFW placement. The reason for this is that nothing in the world is installed where it is supposed to be installed. There are no exceptions in this fact. Tolerances in fabrication, manufacture, and installation are the reason for this. The FW or FFW must be located so that the spool piece will fit within the three dimensions of the shipping box without positioning the spool piece in a skewed or diagonal shipping position. The result of having a skewed spool piece is that it may require too much of the shipping box volume and possibly crowding out other spool pieces in the box. Now, let's have a look at tack weld. It is a weld performed either in the pipe fabrication shop or somewhere else that is only designed to temporarily keep piping components together during their transportation to the installation location. At the location of installation, the tack weld is broken to separate the two components and reposition them for final welding installation. Tack welds are small, dot-like welds that are spaced out along the workpieces. The number of tack welds needed depends on the size of the materials being joined, as well as the geometry, measurements, material thickness, and type of the metal used. Let's see some cases where we have to provide field weld and field fit-up weld. Avoid small pipe pieces if possible, exceeding shipping box length limit by short distances generally permissible in order to do so. In this example, second option is preferred because adding 100 mm of extra pipe of length in 12 meter length of the spool eliminates one shop weld. Field weld in horizontal is preferred. This is preferred, not mandatory, but should be followed wherever possible. Always have at least one fitting attached to a pipe length per spool. Consider placing one FFW for a final field measurement and dimensional adjustment piping between equipment in parallel, like pump and exchangers. Maximize spool wherever possible. So that is it, guys, for today's session. We'll come back with another exciting topic on piping engineering. So till then, take care. Bye-bye.